Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to discuss one of the most important topic of your paper, nanomaterials and application, that is zero dimensional, one dimensional, two dimensional and three dimensional, or it is called as 0D, 1D, 2D and 3D nanostructural materials. Okay, so let's start. So before we have to discuss 0, 1, 2D and 3D nanostructural materials, here somewhat applications we can found the nanostructural materials, or where the nanostructural materials are used. These are the domains where the nanostructural materials are used. So actually, what are the nanostructural materials? Nanostructural materials are nothing but your smart materials or semiconducting materials. Or if we are going to consider any of this instrument, inside this material, inside this instrument, we have two types of working functional capacity, that is your hardware and software. So a hardware can be function whenever a program or a command will be run or execute with the help of integrated circuits. And that integrated circuits are made up of large number of diodes, transistors, capacitors and resistors that we know. And these home appliances or these instruments are used for display purposes, that is, you can say your mobile phone or TV or laptop, memory, power saver, sensor, motherboard and processors. So the integrated circuits, which is made up of diodes, transistors, capacitors, are used for this uses in our day-to-day lives. And these diodes, transistors, capacitors and resistors, or the so-called electronics parts inside this, are made up of smart materials or the so-called semiconducting materials. Now here, have you ever thought that why any product of one company is better than other? Here is the answer. Answer is the quality or performance of a sensor or any equipment for particular application depends on the characteristics. Here it is on. Depends on the characteristics or properties, that means electric, magnetic and optical properties of that material. If the properties or characteristics is better than sensing capacity, then is better. If the characteristics or properties is better, then sensing capacity of that sensor will be better. If the characteristics or properties, that means electric, magnetic and optical properties is better, then sensing capacity obviously will be better. Like one can say that one company's touch screen is better than other. Actually, touch screen is not better, but the material which is used, that is high sensitive than others, than the other. So only for that we can say that this company's touch screen is better than this. But their touch screen is not better. Material whatever used for the touch screen, that is the better. Okay. So now, have you ever thought why it is so? The answer is the quality or performance or the characteristics or the properties can be enhanced by controlling the grain or particle size. So what is grain? What is particle size? On the base of that we are going to be discussing this video in detail. So on the base of the grain and particle size, the whole nanostructural materials are classified into four categories. That is, first is your zero dimensional nanostructural materials, one dimensional, that is your 1D, two dimensional called as 2D, three dimensional or 3D nanostructural materials. So whole nanostructural materials are classified on the base of the particle size into four categorized. Okay, so before we have to move to discuss about 0, 1, 2, 3D nanostructural materials. Here a simple example. Here I given a simple example where nanostructural material is used. That is your automatic on and off the street lights. So this is the street light in the night time. It is blown up, and when the sun rises, automatically it is off. How it is happened? It is happened due to use of the photoresistor or light dependent resistor. This is also it's called the LDR sensor. This is called as photoresistor. This is the instrument, or this is a resistor. Okay, so or this is a sensor. That is your light dependent resistor sensor. Means with light its resistance is going to be changed. So here you can see this is a wire you can found in the form of S like structure. A wire is here in this surface of this instrument. This wire can be changed its resistance, change its resistivity when the light is going to be fall, or if the light intensity is going to be changed on this surface, or when the light is interacted with this material, then its resistivity is going to be changed. So here what is happening for this automatic on and off street lights in the night time, these resistors are connected are over here, okay, and two wires are connected inbuilt emitter somewhere at the bottom of this light. So when the sun rises the light is falls on this resistor where it is connected over here. This is connected over here. So when the light is incidence on this resistor, its resistivity is going to be changed. When the resistivity is going to be changed, the emitter is going to be detect, or the circuit, whatever it is connected, inbuilt circuit, it will detect, and it will sense that the sun rises or the morning time, and automatically that light is off. So this is the simple mechanism of the light dependent resistor, how it is act as a sensor. So here the resistivity of the material can be changed with light. This is the mechanism used to on and off these street lights. Okay, so now this wire is a photoresistor. When the light is going to be incident, its resistivity is going to be changed. Suppose this material is made up of aluminium, or suppose you just consider this material is made up of copper. Okay, now the sensitivity of the copper, whatever is used, is going to be high if the particle size of this copper is going to be reduced. That means initially this is the copper wire. Okay, what was its sensing capacity? It is enhanced when its grain size is reduced. Here again I used the grain size or particle size. So what is the grain size and particle size? whenever this material, this S like wire, is going to be viewed with the high resolution microscopes. See here, I forgot that this wire is made up of large number of grains. So on the base of grain size, its sensitivity will be increase or decrease. Okay, so whenever this material, this copper wire, is going to be viewed with high resolution microscopes, then we can found that this material is made up of large number of grains or particles. So these are the instruments. With the help of these instruments, we can found the grain size of the any material, any sensing or any smart material. So here I have shown three images have been taken from SCM, FESCM and STM. So this is the image viewed with the help of SEM, that is your scanning electron microscope, that you are going to study how it is work. Field FESCM and STEM, these three systems mechanism and how is are in your this paper, nanostructural material paper, you are going to be study in this semester. But here you can see, this is the image where the grain size, these are the grains, okay. So again I am going to be show you, whenever this material, this wire is going to be viewed through this machine, we can found that this type of particles or this type of geometry, some hexagonal or rectangular or irregular shape grains, we can found. These are called as the grains, okay. These are called as the grains. So from the picture we can found, this is a scale 1 micron, 1 micrometer. So here each grain is greater than or equal to 1 micron. The average grain size of this image is 1 micron. So another material's grains has been observed and shown here. This picture is taken by the FESCM machine or microscope. Here you can see that this grain is 1.079 micron and this small grain is 141.4 nanometer. So small grains and large grains can be easily detect with the help of FESCM. And this image has been taken from with the help of scanning tunneling electron microscope. Here you can see that three particles are connected with each other and each particle's dimension approximately or less than 100 nanometer. This is the scale 50 nanometer. So this length is approximately or less than 100 nanometer. This length also less than 100 nanometer. So here whenever a sensing material, whenever the sensing material, this is the sensing material used in this photoresistor. Likewise, we are going to consider this is the mobile phone and its touch screen is made up of a smart material or semiconductor material. Whenever any smart material and semiconductor material is going to be analyzed or going to be viewed through this high resolution microscopes, we can found these type of grains. So here on the base of this grain size, we are going to be classify that material is belongs to 0D or 1D or 2D or 3D nanostructural materials. So the materials in which the grain size is less than that of the 100 nanometer, then those materials are called as nanostructural materials. First, this is the definition of nanostructural material. The materials in which the grain size is less than that of the 100 nanometer, actually it should be modified, the grain size in any direction, suppose this is your x direction, this is your y direction, along x direction if it is nanometer and along y direction it is in micron, then also it will be called as nanostructural material. So on the base of that, it is classified 0D, 1D, 2D and 3D nanostructural materials. So one by one we are going to be discuss in detail. So on the base of this, how we have to change the grain size of a material, and with the change of the grain size, how the material's properties is going to be enhanced, its electric and magnetic properties is enhanced, that work I have been done in my PhD. This is the paper has been published, you can download from its journal site. This is the journal site, this is the JMM paper, you can download from journal site or you can also download from my blogs site, okay. This is a paper, observation of grain size effect on multiferroism means magnetic ferroelectric and ferromagnetic properties, how it is going to be changed, and magnetoelectric coupling, how it has to be changed whenever we are going to be reduce the grain size. That work I have been done in my PhD and it is published in this paper. You can download from here or here. Now, one by one, we start to discuss what is 0D nanostructural material. Here, 0D nanostructural material means it has 0 degree of freedom. Okay. So here, ideally we consider this is a grain. Okay, this box is a grain. Suppose here, see, this box is a fully cubical, and here this the grains are not cubical at all. These are irregular shape. Here you can found it is a hexagonal shape. Here it is very irregular. Here also one grain is very irregular shape. So here our convenience we considered that this is the grain. Like ideally it is a cube. Okay. To understand 0, 1, 2 and 3D nanostructure, we considered the grain that shape is cubical. So first, this is the grain in which its x-axis direction length, here see, I am going to show you, its x-axis, see, suppose this is one grain we are going to be consider here. Suppose this is your x-axis, this is your z-axis and this is your y-axis. So along x-axis length, that means this length, along y-axis, along z-axis, these three lengths we are considering here. So here, suppose this is a grain or ideal grain, its shape is cubic, its length along x-axis, along y-axis, along z-axis, all are less than 100 nanometer. If it is so, then it is called as 0D nanostructural material. So this grain, with the help of these grains, which material is going to be formed, that material will be called as 0D nanostructural material. Okay, that means suppose we have a material whose grains are in all the way. See, suppose we are going to consider this this image here. One particle or this grain has less than or equal to 100 nanometer along all the way, along x-axis, along y-axis, along z-axis. This is less than 100 nanometer. So we can say this is the grain, or with the help of these grains, which material is formed, that material is called as 0D nanostructural material. Suppose we are going to consider this is the material. Whenever this material is going to view with high resolution microscope, suppose viewed by STM, and we found the grain size is this much, 100 nanometer along all the way, then that material I can say, so this material I can say 0D nanostructural material. Suppose this material is viewed through STM and we found that grain size is more than 100 nanometer, or along x-axis only 100 nanometer is there, and other two axes not less than 100 nanometer, it is greater than 100 nanometer, then for that case we can say that grain is called as 2D, two dimensional motion is possible for that grain. That we are going to discuss in detail. So you just focus that if a grain along all the way its dimension is less than 100 nanometer, and with the help of those grain if we made a material, then that material will be called as 0 dimensional nanostructural material. Okay, so here this particle is confined, here along all the way it is confined, along x-axis is less than 100 nanometer, along y-axis 100 nanometer, along z-axis the size is less than 100 nanometer. So that this particle is confined along all three directions. Hence, discrete or quantized energy of the particle That means suppose in this grain we considered a electron, it's trapped. Here particle means electron, okay? Here particle means a charged particle, it's trapped inside this grain. Then we can found the discrete or quantized energy of this electron particle will be observed along three directions. In general, it is represented as this one. E n x n y n z will be equal to pi square h cross square by 2m into n x square by a square plus n y square by b square plus n z square by c square, and corresponding wave function is this one, okay? 2 by a root over of 2 by b into root over of 2 by c into sine n x pi x by a into sine n y pi y by b into sine n z pi z by c. So this type of material or the grain is called as quantum dot. Again, you should not be confused that here I used one thing, that particle or grain, okay? Here I used grains or particles, the material made up of large number of grains or particles, and here I used again particle is electron. So this grain, in the material science language, this grain or one grain can be called as particle as well as grain, okay? So don't be confused. When it will be called as the particle? When it is in the nano dimension, at that time one grain will be called as particle. But here the particle is the charged particle, electron, okay? So this is the real STM image of a nano grain or zero dimensional grain. This is one grain, and with the help of large number of these type of grains, what material is going to be formed, that is called as the 0D nanostructural material. Suppose we are going to consider copper. Copper we synthesized or we prepared in that way, in chemical way, that its particle or grain size is reduced to 50 nanometer. Suppose initially it was 100, it was 500 nanometer or 1 micrometer, but we synthesized or we prepared in a different way, and its grain size reduced to 50 nanometer. And that for this case, when this is reduced to 50 nanometer, then this grain is called as 1D grain. And with the help of this grain, with help of these type of grains, what material is going to be manufactured, that will be called as 0D nanostructural materials, okay? So here, and you can study in your preceding chapters that nanostructural materials have the better characteristics or better performance than the bulk material. Means if its size is going to be reduced, its performance is going to be enhanced. How it is, that you are going to be studying in the next preceding classes. So should not be worried about that. Here we have to only discuss 0D, 1D and 2D nanostructural materials. So here 0D means the particle or the grain size or the dimension of this grain is less than 100 nanometer along all the directions, and the charged particle which is trapped inside this grain, it could not have the free motion along x axis, y axis and z axis. It has the discrete energy levels along all the three directions, and the energy is represented by like this. Wave function of this particle is represented as this, okay? And this type of grain also called as quantum dot, okay? Now we have to consider 1D nanostructural materials. Here now 1D nanostructural materials means 1 degree of freedom. 1 degree of freedom means, here you can see this picture and this picture. Here what I done, the y-axis length I just increased more than 100 nanometer, and along x-axis less than 100 nanometer, along z-axis also less than 100 nanometer. So particle which is inside this box or grain can easily move along y-axis. However, it could not be moved easily or restricted to move along x-axis and z-axis. So, therefore, for this case, the discrete quantized energy of the particle will be observed along two directions only, along x and z. In general, the discrete or quantized energy levels along x-z axis and continuous energy can be written. So along y-axis it is moving freely, means we can get the continuous energy levels. So discrete energy levels, for the discrete energy levels along x and z axis, it is represented by this, and along y-axis the continuous energy represented by this. So this is the total energy expression of the particle in case of 1D nano grain, and with the help of these grains, what material is going to be formed, that will be called as the nanostructural material. So here h cross square k square by 2m, how it came, we know that in classical mechanics, kinetic energy is nothing but half mv square, or it will be p square by 2m, or p we know that h cross k. So here h cross square k along y axis means k y square by 2m, and corresponding wave function will be this one. And here I can give you an example of 1D nanostructural material, that you can see this surface is around 100 nanometer. See, this length is 1 micron, means this length, you can just see this length is less than 100 nanometer or approximately 100 nanometer, and this length, the longitudinal length, is greater than 100 nanometer. So along y-axis or along one direction, the particle is free to move. So we can consider, suppose this is the rod, okay. Also 1D nanostructural material called as nano rod. You just focus upon this rod. If a particle is trapped inside this rod, it can move along this direction freely, okay, but other two directions are restricted. So this direction is considered as y. Along y direction it can be freely move, and energy will be in this form h cross square k y square by 2m, but other two direction it is restricted, the energy will be in the form of this one, and the corresponding wave function is this one. So this is image, it represents the grains of 1D structure. So if we are going to consider one grain, this is one rod means one grain, that is 1D nano grain, one dimensional nano grain, okay. With the help of these grains, if we are made a material, suppose we are prepared copper or we synthesized copper in this format, different synthesis method are there, okay, that also in your course that you are going to study in this paper, hydrothermal synthesis, salt gel synthesis, autocombustion synthesis, different synthesis are there. By using different synthesis, this type of structure we can found. So this is 1D nano grain. So with the help of these grains, collectively grains, whatever the material we are going to be form, that material is called as one dimensional nanostructural materials, okay. So even if one grain itself used for the transistor, remember one grain, this is the one grain. This one grain can be used for the semiconductive material as a transistor. Okay, here I can show you, this is one grain, this nano grain also used as a transistor. So high performance transistors means they are made up of nano grain size, and huge with the small area, large number of transistor can be found. Suppose this is the suppose we are going to be consider a processor, it has the dimension computer processor, the processors made up of nano transistors. So nano transistor means, suppose the transistors made up of 100 nanometers, whatever the performance, if that transistor size is going to be reduced up to 50 nanometer, if I am going to reduce this size, again its performance is going to be enhanced, okay. With that same area, the number of transistor is going to be increased, so performance automatically increase of that processor. So hence year by year the processor generation is enhanced. So this is all about 1D nanostructural material, and we have to go for the 2D nanostructural materials. That is also belongs to 2 degree of freedom. What is the meaning of 2 degree of freedom? Here you can see, compare this figure and this figure. What I done? First I elongated along x y axis, and here I increased the length along x axis. So along y axis it is greater than 100 nanometer, along x axis also greater than 100 nanometer, but only along z axis it is less than 100 nanometer. So the particle or the charged particle, if is inside this grain, then it can be moved freely along y axis, and it can move freely along x axis, but it cannot move freely along z axis. So therefore, for this case, discrete or quantized energy of the particle will be observed along one direction, that is only z direction. In general, the discrete or quantized energy levels along z axis and continuous energy along x and y axis can be written as in this form, and corresponding wave function will be like this. And these materials are nothing but your thin film. You can see the its z component is less than 100 nanometer, but along x axis, y axis, suppose here one electron will be present, it can move this way and this way easily, but along vertically it could not be moved. Vertically it is restricted. So nanostructure materials which have 2 degree of freedom is called as 2D nanostructural materials. Okay, so basically these are called as the thin or thick films. Okay, so now 3D nanostructural materials. So you just compare this figure and this figure. The extra thing is that I dragged this length or increased along z axis. So here you can see that along y axis greater than 100 nanometer, z axis the length is greater than 100 nanometer, and x axis also greater than 100 nanometer. So in this case, the particle can freely move along your z axis, can move freely along x axis, can be moved, also can be moved along any direction freely. So therefore, for this case, no discrete quantized energy of the particle will be observed for this case. Here this case I written 2 times, you just understand. Okay, for this case no quantized energy level we can observe. Along all the direction of the particle can move freely. In general, the total energy of for this case can be written as h cross square kx square by 2m, x cross square ky square by 2m plus h cross square kz square by 2m, and corresponding wave function can be written in this form. And this type of grain is called as bulk grains, and using these grains, whatever the material we are going to be fabricate, that material will be called as 3D nanostructural materials or bulk materials. Okay, so this is the image of the grains or the bulk grains, which is dimension is around 1 micron, which is 10 times greater than that of the 100 nanometer. So these are the bulk grains. Using these grains, whatever the materials we are going to be fabricate or prepare, that material will be called as 3D nanostructural material. Okay, which have 3 degree of freedom. That means the particle can be moved along x axis freely, along y axis freely, along z axis freely, or you can say along any direction freely it can be moved. So here with conclusion, you can found here I represented all the nano grains. This is your 0D grain, where in all the way it is trapped the electron or the particle. This is the grain size or particle size. That means along y axis is it is elongated greater than 100 nanometer, but other two direction has been restricted for the charged particle. In this case, this is your 2D nanostructural material. In this case, along x-axis, along y-axis, the charged particle can freely move, but along z-axis it is restricted. 3D nanostructure means the particle can move freely in any direction. So this is all about your 0D, 1D, 2D and 3D nanostructural materials, and you can collect the detailed note of this topic from my blog itself. And thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you. And here one thing I am going to be share with you, that in your material science language, grains, sometimes called as particle, or it will be also called as crystallite. But ferroelectric and ferromagnetic domains are different concept. Shortly, I can say that ferroelectric domains can be observed inside the grain, particle and crystallites. But ferromagnetic domains can be observed anywhere or any region in the grain, in the material. Wait, suppose this is a small view of a material where we found the grains, okay. So these grains are also called as the particle in the material science language. These grains are also called as the crystallites, but some conditions are there. But ferroelectric and ferromagnetic domains are observed in different positions. That means ferroelectric domains observed only inside the grain or inside the particles, but ferromagnetic domain contains observed inside and outside the grain. That means here you can see, this is the grain, this is another grain, this is nothing but is called as your grain boundary, okay. So the grain boundary, at the grain boundary, ferroelectric domains are not present, but ferromagnetic domains can be present at the grain boundary. So maybe it will be somewhat confused for you, grain, particle, crystallite, ferroelectric, ferromagnetic domains. For that I am going to do a separate video. But this video is only devoted towards 0, 1, 2 and 3D nanostructural materials. Go through this video, and if you want these topics PDF, you can download from here, okay. Thank you once again. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you.